are we even actually hiring him? We should fire him. Those thoughts will come to your mind, isn't it? Just imagine, rather than rushing into the conclusions, just imagine if you give him a chance, if you ask him, just ask him, why so? Why have not you completed your work? And imagine he says, he responds that, sir, I have been on the work since last week. The day you gave it, I am on it. But I have been working continuously. But on Friday evening, I got a call from my grandfather that my grandmother had a heart attack. So she is in hospital since then, and I have to attend her because my grandfather is very old and he is not able to take care of her. So since Friday evening, I have been on the hospital, and today I am standing Monday morning in front of you. But no excuses, sir. I will be on it, and I will finish the work by the end of the day. Now, what you are thinking? Will you fire him? Will you scold him? Well, I think you might consider his case then. You might think, okay, let's give him a chance. Okay, no worry. Do it tomorrow. Do once you are free. So just imagine, rather than jumping into the conclusions in the first place, you actually decided to listen to him. That would have made a difference, right? So coming on to the second story. This story is about a teacher who took a class for 2 days. A teacher who took a class for 2 days for 40-odd students. Once the session was over, what that teacher did was, he made everyone sit, like you are all sitting here. He made everyone sit. And after that, he greeted each and everyone individually by his name, by his or her name. Like, thank you, Akash, thank you, etc., etc. He greeted everyone like that. When that teacher was asked that how did you manage to do that, as I think it is not an easy task to remember 40 odd names in what, 2 sessions. The teacher said that I was eager to listen to them. I, along with my mind, were present completely in the class. We were in the class. Okay, some of you might be wondering that who that teacher is. Okay, so when the teacher was asked, he said that I was completely there listening to you, the stories of you all. That is why I was able to recall all the names at the end of the session. So this is what I have to say about that. Mr. Henry David, a famous American writer, once said, "The greatest compliment I ever had was when one asked me my thought on a particular point, and he attended my thought. He listened to me. That was the greatest compliment I ever had." The key to good listening skills is in the technique. It's a desire to listen. Yes, eye contact, not interrupting the speaker, paraphrasing, etc., etc., are relevant. Those things will help, but the main thing is to have the desire to listen. If we will all have a desire to listen to the speaker, we will surely listen them carefully. Yes, eye contact, etc., will help, but these things also count. But the problem is that we hear to reply, not to understand. Like I am saying something, you are hearing me just to reply me back, but not to understand. That is a main problem. We all are here to develop our speaking skills. Like sir said, we will be working on our soft skills. But in my view, a good listener is first a good speaker. Once you are a good listener, then you can be a good speaker. As my time is almost over, I would just like 1 minute more to conclude it. You people might be thinking that, why am I speaking now? You know, I'm going on and on about listening skills. Why am I here as a speaker? You see, I'm a Marwadi guy. I know how to get my money worth, okay? So the thing is, that I registered as a speaker. I'll be saying here, but I'll be sitting over there and listening to 29, 30 odd beautiful odd stories from you side also. So that's it. It worked both ways, okay? So thank you.